Do you want to change your lifestyle and become a super sexy senorita that can demolish people with a simple stick made of wood? Then you definitely have to pick up Lifestealer Junguru 1680 Fiora! Jungle Fiora is amazingly powerful because she can use a drug to boost her attack speed like a maniac, and if you combine that hack with these two super items, you'll be able to ravenously wriggle the monster's jiggle to gather stacks of Fiora Flare faster than your competitor. Since she's so fast at clearing camps, it is your mission to counter jungle every time it's possible, since the only thing the enemy can do is watch and cry. Want to counter Junguru faster? Then keep a webcam with you at all time to bust in the middle of a Rocky family dinner like a boss. Want to fuck the jungler even harder? Then pretend to be a baby lizard and wait until the police cosplayer happily comes here to slap that ass like there's no tomorrow. But hey, don't spend all your time in the jungle or your teammates will cry all day because you never gank, right? So buy a ticket straight to downtown, charge out the narcissist getting caught in the ice bucket challenge from your superstar duo, go back at the one that threw the bucket and slash her until she's tender enough to be transformed into delicious sushi. She's a really strong pick because she basically has two free flash, which she let her stick to her target like a crazy glue until it gets sent to Teemo's dreamland. That's right, even the safest place in the enemy's eyes is threatened by your presence, since he will never escape from your grasp thanks to your Dragon Ball move. You plan on scuba tower diving without your ultimate skill? No worries, use one charge to take Tarzan's skull go down, and use the other charge on a minion to get away from the turret. QQing is so easy! But if you want to be flashy, you can do something like this even though everybody knows that you just waste a flash. Thanks to your plays, you will plant a deep fear in the other party's hearts so every time you gank, they know shit's going to happen and they won't even waste their effort to run away from your sticky ruler. But if you're the one getting into a 5-some that you never desired, you'll just have to resort to using your well-kept Shinigami skill to put your rivals out of their misery. Ezreal, Ezreal, I bet he's happy that he can finally join Taric to the other side. If you follow my item build, you will lifesteal so much that you can do against that great boss by yourself while your team plays around in the rift. That way, no one will suspect you from giving a head to that giant dildo. What's more, you can still steal the life of these bad boys even when you ultimate! Look, I'm right there! See my life depleting little by little? Then here comes the boom boom bambino and voila! You magically got a second life! Isn't that amazing? Not only do you have surprising life steal, but you also pack a punch so your ruler made of wood feels like a ruler made of latex. Get it? No? Okay, fuck it. So if a Farkavich decides to go ham for no reason, you'll have to punish him for putting that move, and anyone that dares to save his ass will drain him in the afterlife. Boom boom bambino! Boom boom bambino! Boom boom. That's it for today, people! Don't forget to check out my channel for more boring League of Legends video! Feel free to leave a comment in any language you want, but don't only answer those in English and in French because I'm a racist Farkavich! Ciao soup!